You know, listen, of course I'm the top of his list. I'm an annoying bastard when I want to be. I'm well aware of that.
There's an expression that some people in England use called mingy, you know, and it's hard to say which one was mingier. Mark Munoz's haircut or Alan Belcher's tattoo, I don't know, but they're both pretty mingy.
It was if I go out there and I fight my fight, this man can't compete with me. You know, I'll prove that anytime.
Did I just hear you say I can't compete with you? Is that what I heard, everybody?
Is that what I heard?
I was talking to you, Raya, and saying well done. Is that what I heard? Did I hear him say?
You can't say it now that you're in front of the press,
dude.
When we're man to man in the cage, we saw your true colors. We see who you are.
You just said I can't compete with you. I just knocked you out in the first round. Cold. Have you seen that replay, buddy? Your head was bouncing around like a pinball machine.
You're facing Alan Belcher, a fighter who's been calling you out for a long time.
He has an irritating tattoo, and he's a very irritating individual. Yes. Sorry, continue.
Hey, I've said it before. 2 years, 2 weeks, 2 months, 2 days. I don't care. Half of this UFC roster are pussies. They wouldn't take this fight. Jack Ray wouldn't take this fight. Makes me sick. I'll fight anyone, anytime, any place. I've just proved that. I took a fight on 2 weeks' notice. I'm going to walk off a movie set. I'm going to walk into that octagon. I'm going to take Luke Rockhold's belt. He's going to lie on the floor. He's going to wake up looking at the stars. Fuck. This guy just beat me on 2 weeks' notice.
He's still a novice, you know. That's why he's undefeated, because he hasn't been around too long. I used to be undefeated. I'm not anymore because I've been in the UFC for 7 years. I'm pretty sure Chris Weidman was having his nappy change or a diaper change, whatever you want to call it.
Luke is just the opponent. I have no ill will against him. He doesn't bother me, you know. He really doesn't. He's a little dim, you know, in the head. So he doesn't get to me in the slightest.
Jorge Rivera really pissed me off. You know, he really hit a nerve. He did all these stupid videos and, you know, really upset me. And it wasn't fake. It wasn't for the cameras or anything like that. I was really, really annoyed. And I told him, as soon as I laid eyes on him at the press conference for the fight, I said, you're in trouble, mate. You know, because you can talk all the shit you want, but we're going to fight. So I'm going to get my chance to get revenge, you know.
And for the record, that fight went just down like the sparring session that, you know, that is famous. So it's kind of 2-1, really. Rockhold, I know Rockhold. I know what he's capable of. I know he's a very, very good fighter. But the opponent isn't important. This is about me. It's about me fulfilling my destiny. Whether or not it's Luke Rockhold, Muhammad Ali, Godzilla, it doesn't matter. It's going to take a bullet to the brain to stop me on Saturday night.
And that's not a good thing. It's not a good thing. It's a bad haircut and it was a bad tattoo. But fortunately, Mark Munoz, listen, by the way, I did touch on that a little bit when he had that haircut and I talked a little bit of trash about it. But Mark Munoz is one of the nicest guys I've ever met. And he's a very, very nice individual. So I have no problem with Mark Munoz or his head. But, you know, he can grow that. Alan Belcher is stuck with that tattoo for the rest of his life. Apparently it's Johnny Cash. It looks like a fat Elvis. I don't know what he was thinking when he got that done.
People. 2 weeks' notice. I'm ready.
Oh,
doesn't matter. I think.
Wasn't that my line?
Yeah, I'm ready to go.
You just got knocked out. I think you're suspended. Yeah. For a little while, you're suspended. Probably 90 days until you get your MRI
90
checked.
90 days. You take your vacation. I'll be
ready. Bro, you're suspended. Shut the fuck up.